how to create a template in DaVinci Resolve. This is the one thing that is going to save you so much time when it comes to editing your videos every single day, every single week. The biggest thing about the template is it's ready to go. You make a few adjustments and hopefully you'll be ready to go for your next episode. Let's dive in. This is important because templates are going to save you so much time and effort. You can keep coming back to them again and again and again. I think you pretty much are aware of the concept of a template, but boy, when it comes to video editing, there's so much that you can have in place. I'm gonna show you that, and you will be able to save so much time in your next editing. I'm Nick Natarella with AdWise Creative. I've been producing audio, all kinds of audio, and doing voiceovers for radio commercials, national and local, all the way to, if there's certain museums in the country, you might hear my voice on the guided tour. But I've been doing audio for a very long time, and now with this immense explosion of video, thank you COVID, when everybody was locked up and decided to get into something new, businesses are turning to YouTube like never before, and I absolutely love this opportunity. One of the things that will help you, because if you've seen any of my videos, you'll know that I encourage you to be cranking out five a week if you can pull it off. Well, one of the major things that's going to help you speed up the entire process is editing and using templates in your editing. This is going to be a significant point. Why do you want to do that? Because you've got all your, well, first of all, for efficiency. Number one, you don't lose track of all the elements that you need to use again and again and again. What would happen if, oh, say you got really going and you thought you were done with your video and, oh, you forgot to add the background music? It's really easy to overlook background music. A lot easier to miss background music than, say, your logo. You're probably gonna remember your logo, but then there's an opportunity to miss that as well. You never know what you're gonna miss. So when you have your templates already built, you've got all the elements that you're going to need. And they're very simple to modify and add. Say if you did forget something, you can always put that in your template, resave it, and then call it up the next time. But this is something that you're going to use over and over and over again. And there are a couple of different ways you can use it. A couple of different ways that I use templates are by client. For example, if a client has the same voiceover and the same background music, once I edit one of my, say, radio commercials, I will have the EQ and the compression already set to that vocalist. And I know I'm going to be using that vocalist, that same VO talent, over and over and over again for this particular client. That's who they've chosen. So now that I've got that stuff set, all I have to do is drop in their new audio every time. We've got their music, get rid of the flubs, take care of the breaths, that kind of thing. But for the most part, all you're going to be doing is some fine tuning and adjustment, and you should be good to go, as opposed to building it from scratch every single time. Another way to do it is by project. It's very easy. I've got a couple podcast clients. They've got some very complex intros and outros. Two things you can do with that. You create the intro and then mix it down, so it's one file. We've built it from a couple sound effects, some background music, their voiceover, that kind of thing. There are five or six elements to the intro and the outro, but when you mix them down, you only have two files now. They are now in place and ready to go. Their background music, in place and ready to go. Same thing with the other, well, slight variation on another podcast client. They have theirs already pre-produced. One I have pre-produced to two separate files. The other one, I've got all the files I need, so if I need to do some fine adjusting across the entire intro or outro, I can. That one's got a slightly different structure to it. There's a customized intro for every single episode. So some of that intro needs to kind of float a little bit, so I decided to go with the individual pieces. As opposed to the other podcast, that's just pre-produced every time, it's ready to go no matter what. So there's several different ways you can use this. And then the elements to your template, I've already mentioned several of them. Music, sound effects, intros and outros, maybe some consistent voiceovers. But let's dig a little deeper too. Let's say for your videos, if you're always going to be shooting in the same place, I wouldn't recommend some type of color correction because no matter what, you could mess with the lighting and things could be slightly different, but you might want to throw some color correction in the template. If you know you're going to be using it again and again and again, it might be consistent, but then some things with the voiceover. If it's going to be the same person for the voiceover every single time, you can probably dial in your EQ and you can get your compression kind of set. Again, with some minor tweaking, those can be on your audio tracks, ready to go. Any type of reverb setting that you want to use, if you want to use one, that can be pre-dialed in. Any type of noise reduction or something like that that you're going to be using, have that in the audio track already. Have them already built in the sequence that you want. How do you want it? You can even put your mastering on your main channel, have it chosen, everything is ready to go, and again, drop in the new elements, whether it be video or audio, and then tweak it just a little bit. You should be within range, and it shouldn't be like building it from scratch. So if there's any of this that you'd like to get a deep dive on, like maybe EQ or compression or something like that, I don't want to necessarily do a really deep dive on something because we're all about simplicity and efficiency around here and getting your business podcast or your business YouTube channel or your business blogging up and running. But anything you want me to cover regarding those subjects, put it in the comments below. Like and share. Are there any other friends that you know that are getting a business, that have a business and might benefit from this kind of content? Be sure that they know about it as well. So, we've talked about it all. Let's take a look and see how it all plays out. So now that we know what a template is for, let me just do a simple one for you so you can understand what is going to be part of, what are the components and how do we lay out a template for, let's say, a podcast. So let's start out by building a podcast template. I've already introduced a few elements that I start to work with. Of course, the introduction and the intro and the outro are two elements that will be found in every single episode. So I'm going to take these from my media bin and I'm going to drag them into place. And let's put, actually, I'm going to move this down because I'm reserving video one and video two are going to be my host and my guest. Every once in a while, we get this right. And we're going to do a video. We're going to save video one and two for the guest. And I'm just going to make audio three will be the intro and outro channel. So there's my intro. Boom, done. Now I'm going to take the outro and put it in place. Let's shorten this just a little bit. And what I'm going to do is take the outro and I'm going to put it down here. And let's say, so right now I'm only got a 2-minute podcast. So I am going to take this and now we're up to 4 minutes. Ooh. And I'm going to take this. It's about a 30 to 45 minute podcast, so I'm going to just put the outro right there. Now, to go with that outro, I'm also going to add her logo. Well, I'm going to put that, since it's going to go with the intro and outro, I'm going to put this in video three. Now, look, it's really tiny, so I got to zoom in quite a bit just to see it. So let's... Here we go. I'm going to make sure it stays on three. That goes right to there. And this goes all the way to here. So there I've stretched out her logo all the way through the intro. Now I know somewhere right about, you can kind of see, this is where the talking ends. And this is just the theme music. And the actual discussion is going to start right about here. So I'm going to shorten this just for the heck of it, because I know somewhere right in this area is where I'm going to start the actual video and the audio from the interview. So I just shorten that up a little bit. And then this is probably going to come back to here. And I'm going to go ahead. Oh, I hate this. There we go. I'm going to go ahead and fade that out just a little bit. Same thing happens over here. Let's go back to our outro at the very end. And again, I'm going to put the logo on track three. And it's going to fade out at the end
notice right about here, this is music, and then right here is about where the outro kicks in. So I'm just going to generally stretch it to here for now. And then I'm also going to have some lower thirds as well. We need, here are a couple that I'm going to add for titles. The host, I'm going to put her lower third. Right here. And then the guest right here. Now notice, there's a lower third to the left, and there's a lower third to the right. So either one I can change. And if I need to swap them around and use them for, you know, if this is the host and that's the guest, or this is the host and that's the guest, depending on which way they set up on the Zoom call, that's how it'll be. I can flip-flop them back and forth very easily. So let's get this zoomed out. Okay, there we go. And what I'm going to do is get these all the way at the beginning, because once I set them, I'll be able to copy them and distribute them throughout the entire interview. So there they go there. And then I'm also going to have, say, a middle lower third. And I'm going to put this one up here. This is going to be, it didn't take. There. This is going to be, let's open our inspector. This one I'm going to call email and website. So I'm going to go ahead and make these adjustments. You see how it's already over that? I'm going to take this. I'm going to shrink it down a little bit. And I'm going to move it more to the top. So the email and website are going to show up down at the bottom. Now for the email and website, let's adjust that position just a little bit. And there's the website. And now I've left room down here for the subtitles. So now I've got this spaced out a little bit. It ain't pretty, but for time's sake, I want to make this nice and short and condensed. And let's do this one. Let's call this guest website, guest name. And then again over here, you can do host website, host name. Let's get rid of that space there. There we go. So that you'll end up, you can just type in right now, you know your host website, you know your host name, and you know the host website. So those we can just fill in right now. And again, I'm not going to put them in here because they may flip-flop. So there are those elements. That's pretty much what you're going to need. From time to time, the Zoom call is recorded, say, in gallery view. So on the right side of your screen, you're going to have one of them, let's say the guest, and then the right side will be the host. Well, every once in a while, I want to isolate one from the other. Sometimes when the guest is talking, I'll zoom in on them. Sometimes when the host is talking and asking a question, I'll zoom in on them. Well, I've got these two things that I use that I've created. I put them in my power bins so they can be available for every single project that I do. What I have is screen left and screen right. What that does, and I'm going to drop them on top of the logo so you can see what happens. I'm going to drop them right here. And now we've zoomed in on half of the screen. So I can use this with the video to be able to zoom in from time to time and isolate from the other side of the screen. So what we've done is we've kind of effectively given ourselves a kind of a three-camera setup. We've got one camera where you see everybody in the middle, and then we've got a camera on the left and a camera on the right to isolate when the guest is speaking or when the host is speaking. So I've got these elements in here, and now what I'm going to do, and this is a key step right here. Now, the key element to naming this project, you have to be, as kind of a reminder, you don't want to save over this. you're going to want to save this as a separate entity. Okay? So what I can do is I'll do save project as, and I will be sure to put the name template open in read only. That's my little clue to be sure to save this, to open it in read only mode. That way I can't save over my template. And I've got everything squared away, and it's always the same every time I open it, and it's ready to go. So does that make sense? Now you see how to use a template. You've got it ready to go. All I need to do is drop in the new audio and video, and we are all set. I hope that helps. Presets and templates are going to save you tons of time in your editing.
So that's how you create your templates. I hope you found it easy to do, because I know it's going to make your editing a lot easier. That's for sure. Now, you can apply this across the board. I was specifically talking about DaVinci Resolve here, which also kind of does fit the category I'm going to tell you about right now. I have a free video editing software guide. The guide is free, and it's all about free software. So go in the description down below, click on that link, and get your copy of the guide today, and you'll have several different video softwares to choose from, and you can probably get started this afternoon. Get your copy in the description down below. I'm Nick Natarella with AdWise Creative. Thank you for watching.